one I have in Gwent cards from my original playthrough 5 years ago, and what I managed to pull off this time around. Hell, I take a look at the achievement, or, literally, GOG and Steam didn't give a fuck. It's like, Microsoft, you do not have a patent on this, so fuck you. And we're just going to make them achievements. But they're after the fact things, because I think they were implemented in... It wasn't GOG Galaxy stuff. It was something where I was done with The Witcher 3, 5 years ago. Not the Game of the Year edition. And they implemented it. It's like, hey, by the way, we got achievements now. It's like, cool. Oh, yeah. So, old man.
War. Curious to know your opinion.
Well, I believe Emir's chosen a poor time to wage it.
How do you figure?
Better as I see it, with the North now in disarray.
The North is weak, true. But I give the impression the Emperor is dealing with some domestic strife. Far too much to start a war. Radovid is a madman.
Yeah.
He's certain to take advantage.
It's the internal strife that actually hinders his expansion. The war, not the external elements.
Congratulations.
I thank you.
I don't know what a Hydrophant is.
He chose me years ago, about the time when the old disputes between the clans were reigniting.
Job's been mainly politics then.
Aye, but I've not minded. Since time immemorial, the druids have wandered betwixt the clans, keeping endless feuds in check. We care for equilibrium, the balance of all things, not just trout populations and streams. We're lucky the Jarls always valued us as advisors.
Nah, crack. Told you go fuck yourself, because you got in the way between the investigation and me and Yen. Well, Yen and I.
I went to Hindersfjall.
Oh? Did you learn anything?
Ciri came through Lofoten. She was wounded when she arrived. Villagers nursed her back to health. Sadly, the Wild Hunt was on her trail.
Yeah, she didn't get any of that deep dickin'.
Ciri managed to escape. Villagers.
I know.
That's my fault.
Needn't finish.
Yep.
I later spoke to those who survived. Suffice to say, Ciri was fortunate to escape. I trust you'll find her soon.
No. No, I'm not gonna find her for at least another 40 hours.
Farewell.
Thank you, though. I appreciate that. Not clemency, but trying to appeal. Appealing to somebody's fears and worries, and it's like, now, what's that called? It's between shit and pathetic. Empathy. I appreciate your empathy. Yes, that's it. That's not how that word works. Alright. I've hit everything I wanted. Took care of those custom waypoint markers. Still haven't dealt with those. Yes. No. Where are you then? Shields. No,
wait. Ha! Nary a soul for months. Then one day guests from afar start dropping like rain in springtime. You weary traveler? Hungry?
I'm looking for a young woman by the name of Ceres.
Looking for Ceres, Jarl on Crate's daughter.
Ah, you found her. Or near to. Lass was just here.
Know where she might have gone?
Took an interest in our Jarl. Asked about his childhood. So I told her to see Big Thora and Eirik.
So Jarl is a term for leader, like a general term. It doesn't...
Who are Big Thora and Eirik?
Years ago, Eirik was close with the old Jarl. Was the Jarl that helped him win Big Thora's hand. They lived toward the east end of the village.
Okay, thank you.
Take care.
I guess I'll wander a little bit east.
To Ceres when you see her.
Hey, Big Thora, hey. Is he... I thought I needed to go east, but apparently, oh, he's above. Ah, I need to get a little bit of elevation. Really? You're Bergthal? No, you're the fisherman. Yeah, I'm just gonna talk to everybody.
You need something?
You're labeled as fisherman. Are you Bergthal? I'm looking for Saris, for fuck's sakes. Can you... time is a very fluid thing. Like, how long is a while? Like, a few moments, an hour or so? Did you take a shit and she wandered in another direction? Like, how long has this while been, you... moron, idiot person.
Greetings.
Hello, chicken. Woman. The person.
Lucky chap you are, then. Truth be told, I'm taken. But village is brimming with lovely girls.
No, it's not. Wait, lovely, you say. Can I meet them?
Girls? Where? Maybe one would be willing to show me around the island.
Well, there's Thea. Lovely one. Cooper's daughter. Though, nah, she's got teeth like fish hooks. Now, Deborah. There's a fine lass. Teeth bang on straight. Though there is a growth under her right eye.
Your definition of lovely is really losing a lot of its luster.
Ah, nuts. Now I give it a think. Well, none of these lasses are really appealing.
And you're a fucking catch, I imagine.
I'm looking for Saris.
The skinny thing. Lovely doe eyes, true.
Skinny?
She's got an horrible house. But the lass is gaunt as a sapling.
I don't know where she is, and her father...
Ugh, tell Crack to calm down. No Skellige lass can perish in her own isles.
That's oh, not true.
Went to find me man Eirik. Needed to talk, she said.
Eirik.
She'll be on the beach, t'other side of the isle.
Thanks. Take care.
Good luck searching.
Yeah, well, it's not really a search. It's more of a... Motherfucker, you shooting arrows over my shoulder, I will kill you and your hater friend lady that's just like, oh, there's a bunch of pretty ladies. Oh, wait, never mind, they're all fucking ugly. It's like, come on. Why you gotta be this way? Who hurt you? That's a big question, but... Wait, we're gonna find Eirik by the shore? No, Eirik is... Yeah, I don't remember the livestock just bunging up in massive crowds like this before, but... Oh! Well, hello, friends. It's been a little while. Has it? But, you know, for me, it's been a bit of a time since I'm like, you know what? Fuck drowners and drown dead and Makubababaraz. As is always, have turned off the enemy scaling. No, enemy scaling is on. Fuck it. That's why they're level 28.
But if not for me warning, you'd be heron bait about now.
No, the smell of piss and fear. And if not for my help?
Not for me, you'd have sat on that rock till you died and rotted.
For the love of Freya, all right. Have it your way. You saved me, now what? What, need I march around the country singing in your praises?
No, just tell me where to find Saris.
Must be daft. You helped me with the sea devils, but that don't mean I'm willing to gossip about Uncrake's daughter.
It's not gossip, you fucking moron idiot. Tell me where she is.
Where's Saris? Tell me.
I'll take the 40 points. Idiot fucking moron.
Just about our Jarl and his family.
Went to Odeldrick's old family home. Yonder on the hill.
Thanks. That's why you put points into Axie. Fuck. Almost on the verge of just being like, I'm going to kill you. Because your ignorant stupidity and just your general existence pisses me off. Alright. What the fuck? Not going that way. Okay. Just going to fast travel. Literally, you'd have to find a way over there. And it's like, do you want to crawl over the mountains? Do you want to, try to, not sequence break, but, Skyrim it up the goddamn mountainside? No? Maybe? Possibly? Roach, can you fucking please? I look forward to our conversation, Roach. That's not happening for... Look forward to episode 255 of Garrett Plays With Himself in The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. Wow. Yeah. I remember sequence breaking over this because I jumped over the little cabin there. But it should be open now? Yes. Of me having a conversation with Roach in the Blood and Wine DLC. Excuse me. Did I not sequence break it? Is that how you're literally supposed to... Wait, no, there's a door. Fuck. Okay. Shit on me. Something seriously wrong here. Those sound like ghosts?
Fresh footprints. Could be Ceres's.
Yeah, potentially, and also the hidden hatch underneath the place. Shit's locked. Of course it's locked. Now there's the key to the cellar. I'll just take that. Thank you very much. These remind me of the prison cells in...
Ceres.
Ah, shit.
Gotta get her out of here.
I need to go to a cellar. I'll come back to you, cellar. Ceres, don't lock me in. What?
What happened? Where am I?
Wait, did you try to fight some fucking spook?
Just awful.
Got hit with something heavy.
Geralt? Why are you here?
Came to look for you. Croc's worried. Taking you home.
I won't go until I help Ulrich. The sword! Where's the sword? I've got to go back!
You're not going anywhere.
Fuck you.
I carried you out of there a moment ago, half dead.
I have to!
You have to tell me what's going on.
What's up with this house?
Why'd you go in there?
I wanted to help Udalric.
Who's Udalric?
I don't see how your stroll through a haunted house will help him.
It would have if I'd only found the sword.
The sword. So what about the sword?
It's Brokvar, the ancestral sword of Udalric's clan. I needed to lift the curse that holds Udalric.
A curse?
Long story. Years ago, Udalric and his little brother butted heads over the sword. As custom has it, the clan's sword should go to the firstborn son, Udalric. But his father gave Brokvar to his little brother, Aki.
Serious insult in these lands.
Serious enough for Udalric to break a sacred law here in Skellige. He openly questioned his father's decision.
I thought it would be patricide, but...
He chained Udalric to a pile, up to his waist in the sea. Spent 3 days like that. When his punishment ended, he and Aki sailed out to fish.
Did they catch parts of Udalric, or... I imagine something happened on that trip.
Got a feeling this trip didn't end happily.
Your feeling's right. There was an accident.
No, there was an incident. An accident is something that's preventable.
Udalric had his hands full with the sails. Didn't hear his brother until it was too late.
Didn't hear? or didn't want to hear.
No, it might have been deafened by. Same doubt,
but none would mention it aloud.
So you think Ulrich killed his brother?
What do you think? Did Ulrich kill Aki?
I don't want to jump to any conclusions. But I do think whatever happened at sea that day, well, it's affecting Ulrich right now. Powerfully so. And it could have something to do with that sword.
So,
what did you plan to do with the sword?
Cleanse the curse, or...?
The brother's ghost?
Long as I remember, folk have said Udalric's the chosen one. The one the gods speak to. I believed it once. But now, considering certain things, I think he's just haunted. And it's his dead brother that's haunting him.
You came about that yourself, or...? Where did you come to that conclusion?
Not breaking any of your laws just by thinking it.
Don't care. I don't believe it's the gods talking. Have you seen him? He's covered in scars.
Thought he earned those in battle.
If you call the strife in his heart and head a battle, I've asked him about it. He said the voices command him to hurt himself for the glory of the gods. I think not. It's not the gods. It's Aki.
Yeah, his brother... demanding.
So you believe Aki's getting his revenge, because Udalric let him die?
I've talked to Yort. He swears Udalric didn't start hearing voices till after Aki's death. And I don't think Yort's mistaken. He knew both those boys from the cradle. I think we've to give Brokvar to Aki, and he'll leave Udalric alone.
Not a bad idea, on condition it's a ghost we're dealing with. But something doesn't add up.
What's that?
Aki drowned at sea, said so yourself. But the ghost haunts this house.
Aki and Udalric both lived here. Maybe that's why. Thanks for your help, Geralt. But I've got to get the sword.
Out of the question. I'll get it.
Really? Thanks. So I can go see Udalric?
No chance. You're weak. Might pass out again along the way. Wait here, we'll go together.
Come on, Geralt. Don't put it that way, dude. That's not cool. Fuck. Why are you gonna put it that way? There's different ways of saying it. Fuck. No, I'm... A? I have that key? Goddamn fuck right I do? You know what? I'm just going to... check this level before I wander into the basement again. Alright, just a plate. Beggars cannot be choosers. I wish I was more of a chooser than a beggar, but alright, well, I'll go with the lot in life that you got. Can't. So there's no upper floor. Huh. Snake eater. Yeah, once I run across somebody that seems relatively pissed off. See? Bokvar.
What is this about?
Seems spooky. You know what? You want hiding in shadows? Fucking enjoy hiding in shadows while I light all the candles, you cunt. Eh, what you think about that? Eh? You bastard. Now, this is way too far. And there's been many instances where I'm like, I don't remember this part of the game. I, you know, have the hard cliff notes. But anything beyond that, it does not exist in my brain anymore. Kind of vented to make space for important things like, hey, remember to eat and shit and such. I imagine I'm good on spectral oil. Just out of general curiosity. Hey, Cirrus.
So, did you find the sword?
I did, but I think there was something watching it. Like,
after you, then.
Super pissed watching it.
You were mates once, right?
Hope we still are.
But, well, I heard you fell out over something or someone.
I didn't
that story with Yennefer
agree.
Ago,
that was my wife.
In fact, that was before Croc met the woman who'd be your mother.
But you and Yennefer already met?
Things were never cut and dried with Yen.
What is it about her? What is it that draws you?
Dunno. Maybe, it's because I've never chosen comfort and ease, the calm and the quiet.
Want to keep an eye on him?
He's here for the flesh.
So wait, fucking what? Like, I fought an ice giant for the one. I can't remember exactly what I had to kill, but I had to help some. I had to fuck up some shit for.
Where's Yennefer?
Madman Lugos' boy.
Why do you ask?
I just wonder why she let you come here alone.
What do you mean, let me?
Oh.
Nothing. Not a thing. Just got the impression she doesn't like to let you out of her sight. Look, there they are.
Wait.
Already bright out here. Stings the eyes.
Oh.
The fresh air will do you good. The gods won't be pleased.
Idiot drunk.
Jarl,
hey.
Our guests, remember.
So what happened?
What happened to your hand?
I sacrificed it to the gods.
Forgive him, Jarl. Geralt's got more to learn about our customs. We're close to the gods in Skellige. And the chummier you are, the greater the offering you make. It's our belief that the greatest thing a man can offer is his pain, his suffering, the pure sacrifice.
Drop my controller again.
A gift, not a sacrifice.
So about those voices, then.
These voices you hear.
The gods, their voices.
Mm-mm. No, 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 no. I don't have anything to back this up.
More likely, this is somehow related to your dead brother.
I told Geralt of Aki. We concluded that...
That the gods are angry at you, yet he's the reason. That's why you have to apologize to Aki himself.
I didn't want to. Aki fell in the water.
Yeah. Not a great swimmer. He was holding my lucky stone.
Let me help you, and I promise to do everything I can to keep from angering the gods.
Heed the Witcher, Jarl. Make amends to Aki, and you'll surely please the gods.
Why is there a random baby here? Sorry, what the fuck?
Remember where Aki fell in the water?
Near the Isle's eastern end, by the mouth of the bay. Current had swept us towards Ulula's Needle.
It's a dangerous spot. Treacherous eddies swallow a handful of sailors each year.
We need to sail there. Aki's ghost won't rest until Brockvar's return to his remains.
No. No, no, no. The gods, they'll be angry. I feel it.
Yeah.
No, Jarl, the gods love you, and they loved Aki.
God, your nose is Gavin Free big.
The sword should be returned. That's what matters. Makes no difference by whose hand.
You only notice it really in the side profile.
Aki, that'll help me recognize him. Something he was wearing that could survive all this time underwater.
Aye. Our clan ring.
That ought to be enough. I'm off.
That carpenter. These continental dandies come a strutting, then we gotta drag their corpses out of the inn.
Serious?
Got a minute? Sad when someone like Bran dies. Everyone says he was a good king.
It's not fitting to speak elsewise about the dead.
Mean you don't agree?
Bran spent his life at sea. And while he was away, old feuds flared, devouring the Isles from the inside. Folk grew furious, came when there was no one to mediate, resolve quarrels. But Then Bran would return with loot, throw a feast, let the mead flow in rivers, and everyone loved him again.
He was more concerned about the external threats and let the internal threats fester. Kind of like a cancer.
Farewell.
Honestly, I have no intention of talking to the other boys, although I would love to have a little bit more lore and context and just listening to people's goddamn good voice acting. No, that's not what I want. There's no mod that I have on to be like, hey, more animals, by the way. Just gonna... Oh, I thought I was gonna die from that. Alright, fucker. No, I need you to die. Wow. So it seems that parrying is something that I have to reserve for humans. Got it. How about the rest of you cunts? Anyone coming up here for some of this? No? I don't think I ever got a chance to place Bokovar.
Must be the place.
On Aki's bones, because... Wait, do I still have... No, I have a breath meter. Fuck's sakes, god damn it. Wait, do I still have Yennefer's fucking, hey, you can breathe forever and ever and ever? No, I don't have that. Took me way too long to acknowledge the fact that it's like, hey, by the way, Lamau. That's... Well, there's a breath gauge. There's literally a breath gauge. Hello, hello, hello. What is this? Thank you, question mark. Saves me some time. Well, I give him that sword back.
Yeah, I'm wondering what that accomplished, if anything. Time to see Udalric.
But I'm not done with the environment here. There are things to see. Treasure. To... get? I guess? Maybe? Perhaps? No, maybe there is no treasure here. There ain't no treasure here. Nah, that's not how it goes. It's shelter. Shelter's... you know, a treasure to a lot of people that... wish that was a commodity that they could enjoy. I forget far too often how absolutely beautiful this game is. Ah, great, great cry, dude. Wait, no one cares because you're dead. Dead bitches making a lot of noise and having nothing to offer to it. Offer to the usefulness of their noise making conversation, I suppose, is what I'm talking about in general. Just like, yeah. Big angry war cry. And now you're dead.